the main event.
And it was about that time. It was about that time that we went ahead and injected a little bit of star power. Let me talk to you. I'm going to put it to you like this. Don't worry about what I'm doing here. You go ahead and take a walk in cell. Ain't nobody trying to hear your prepubescent voice.
I agree.
Right back over here, at least we got somebody with a little bit of bass in their voice. But look at it this way, Wade. I ain't here to suck up to you, because if you so much as look at me the wrong way, I'll drag your ass out of retirement just to walk you right back in. Oh, wait a minute.
Hey,
look at this awkward idiot standing here. Barstool Sports. And just the same way that you see these bewildered, cross-eyed, half-wit, confused faces behind me right now, in short order, they're going to be looking at each other. They're going to say, oh, my God, whose game is it? It's LA Knight's game.
With the advent of LA Knight walking in the door, already people around the world are saying, oh, wow, LA Knight might already be the greatest NXT superstar of all time. So it's no surprise that you're here knocking my door. But if you come around knocking my door unexpected again, I'm going to do some knocking myself. I'll knock your damn head off. Now get out.
Because at the end of the day, every single one of your favorite NXT superstars, every one of them holds a golden ticket, a first-class ticket to getting stomped out by L.A. Knight. Don't think I'm about to come out here and talk about childhood dreams. What, you think standing in here, you think this is a dream? Nah. This is business. This is my business. My business involves me whipping another man's ass anytime he steps between these ropes. And you might say, hey man, that guy's the Tom Brady of wrestling. Nah. Tom Brady wishes he was half the man as L.A. Knight. Because I look around the landscape of NXT. You got your Johnny Garganos. You got your Kyle O'Reillys. You got your Adam Coles. Hell, you got your Finn Balors. Every single one of them, they got their fancy little kicks. They got their flips. They got their dives. I'm inviting each one of you. Bring that to my front door. I ain't gonna meet you with flash. I ain't gonna meet you with pizzazz. I simply will beat the absolute hell out of you.
And you're talking about a man walking right into the Gauntlet Eliminator. And what happened last week? 11 guys got dumped. Tonight, 5 guys get dropped. After tonight, 24 hours from now, Johnny Gargano, old Johnny Wrestling. They call him the Legend of Takeover, right? Well, guess what? Legends fall and new legends take over. Mackenzie, after last week, you and everybody are just talking about Kyle O'Reilly coming out of the shadow of Adam Cole, right? Wrong. Because everybody is talking about me putting up the W on that mustache moron Dexter Lumis.
The ruler's back. And what that means is a bunch of incels are out here gonna be saying my name in a minute. But just because you say L.A. Knight, that don't make you cool. And speaking of not cool, I'm gonna give new meaning to the name Jake Atlas tonight. Because I'm gonna punt your ass so far down the street, you're gonna need an Atlas just to fight it. Yeah!
So then we close out this Sunday in your house with that bedraggled idiot, Cameron Grimes, getting his ass kicked in. While everybody around the world, including his idol Ted DiBiase, is out there just laughing at him. That's enough.
So this Sunday, whether I need to walk into this ring and knock that clown's head off, or whether I need to climb this ladder rung by rung to prove it, there is no hill I won't climb or hillbilly I won't step on, because there's only one man who can carry that million-dollar legacy, and it's not this hill, Jack. It's me.
I still, like, just to have this on my shoulder right now is beyond description. I've learned so much from the Million Dollar Man just in the last few weeks, but, I mean, if you consider my entire life, like I said, you were a fixture. I learned so much. And now I've got everything that I want. And now that I have everything that I want, it's time to drop what I don't need.
I drop what I don't need. And what don't I need?
I don't need an old man like Ted DiBiase trying to board this gravy train, trying to ride my coattails. Nah, nah. Then the ingrates in attendance, the NXT Universe chant, to the moon, to the moon. And out comes that hill jack himself, Cameron Grimes. Good on you, Cameron Grimes, because as far as I knew, I thought you cared about this. I thought you cared about the money. Turns out, you care about the old man. Well, ain't that sweet? You are exactly what I knew you were from day one, and that is 100% moron idiot. Remember that fall you took at In Your House on the ladder? My God, it was beautiful.
This is more like it.
Cameron Grimes wins! Yay!
And nobody gave a damn! I stand here and I look at you, I see a natural born loser. Next week, I tell you what then, why don't we go ahead, me, you, Great American Bash, this title, it, nah, nah. In the transformation to the Million Dollar Man, but let's be honest, I'm well beyond the Million Dollar Man. I am the Million Dollar Megastar L.A. Knight. Nobody asked any of you incels. Great American Bash next week. Me, you, this title on the line. But if you lose, and lose you most certainly will, you become my butler.
Why don't we take a walk? You want to take a walk with me? No, I'm just kidding. I ain't going anywhere with you. You think the Million Dollar Megastar is going to take a walk with you? Let me talk to you. Well, Cameron Grimes, I hope you got your plunger working. I hope you got your toilet brush. Hope you brought all the plumbing gear you need. I got some toilets for you to clean. I got some cars for you to clean. Hell, I got some meals for you to cook for me. You want to come over and have a meal? Cameron will cook it for you. You have to eat outside. Don't let you in.
And now you're talking about I got my own butler. This troglodyte's on his way. He's actually late right now.
Listen, I'm late, all right? I get it, but I showed up. So step out of the way because I'm here to uphold my end of the bargain. Because I'm going to the broom.
The only place you're going looking like this is to the toilet. So why don't you go ahead and meet me out back and we'll make you look professional.
Out back?
Out back. Meet me there.
I look so good. You know, I wasn't thinking the gloves were a good choice, but I look great.
You look good. You look like a damn penguin. So let's get some things straight here. First thing, slow down. You walk a couple steps behind me. From here on out, you're going to call me Mr. Knight. You're going to call me Sir. And what I'm going to have you do is, my butler, your first task, I'm going to need you to mow this lawn.
This lawn right here?
Yeah.
No problem. Wait till I get on this bush hog. I'll have this thing mowed.
Hold on. I don't know what a bush hog is, but I'm not giving you the keys to that thing. If you're mowing this lawn, you're going to mow it with this. Okay? I like details. This is going to get that done. No. I'm telling you, we would have gotten here 10 minutes quicker had you listened to me instead of the dopey GPS. Get the bags, butler. Go about your business. Go.
I'm not going anywhere. And by the looks of things, hanging out with you, he needs all the help he can get.
Yeah, well, you're going to need all the help you can get if you keep talking like that. Is it bring your idiot to work day? Who brought you?
Oh, come on, lads. What's the holdup?
Man, I thought the standards were a little higher around here, but obviously they aren't if they're letting you guys in, huh?
Don't
is this a big momentous occasion? What number show is this?
Number 40.
Number 40?
40.
How'd you make it past 2?
Oh, you watched the show? We tried to call you.
I didn't even know this
you...
was a show before yesterday. I told him he looked like crap. I told him he's wearing this wrinkly shirt. I told him he could probably use a couple cups of coffee. Look at his eyes right now. You can tell he's barely awake.
You are the Million Dollar Champion, so how does that make you feel?
Well,
yeah, tell him how it makes you feel.
You're not talking right now.
I've beaten him twice. I do not need to do it again. You can feed him all the false hope you want, but here's the deal. At TakeOver 36, when I beat him for the third time for this title, Ted, he won't be my butler. You will. I'll own this belt, and I'll own you.
I almost want to say I'm going to miss this, but let's be honest. Can you get any better than the Million Dollar Butler, Ted DiBiase, after I beat you at TakeOver this Sunday? Phenomenal. Give me water.
Cameron Grimes wanted to come out and save the old man after the old man got a little too, we'll say cheeky. How about that, okay? He got a little bit too full of himself, thought all of a sudden there's money coming to him. No, no, no. What you got? Stiff right hand. Back in your seat, old man. And then Cameron Grimes said, oh, let me come out and help you. And I said, oh, okay, yeah, come on out and help him. Ah, dropped on his head for his trouble.
Here we are. The Million Dollar Championship goes off with some hillbilly Cameron Grimes. Now he gets to live his dreams happily ever after with Ted DiBiase. Yay! And nobody cares.
And a TakeOver 30. 36, I watched you take all night long to take out a guy who'd have taken me 43 and a half seconds to dust. So with that in mind, Joe, if you got enough tingle in your loins, I'm here to be your first challenger, which coincidentally means it'll be your last challenger when I take that NXT title.
You know, there's some of the NXT faithful out there that go, oh, not LA Knight, he's a jerk. Quit your crying, quit your belly aching, because here's how it goes down. You're going to be doing a whole lot of crying. You're going to be doing a whole lot of belly aching as I smack around three of your favorites, and I become the number one contender, and then Samoa Joe has to look into these eyes and realize that his time is up.
God, you're as giddy as a schoolgirl right now. It's exciting, isn't it? What can I help you with?
Sir, my name is Bron Breakker, and tonight is NXT 2.0, and I want a chance to prove myself.
Okay, it is NXT 2.0. It's also the LA Knight Show, because tonight I'm going to become the NXT champion. But first, I tell you what, in 2 minutes, why don't you walk out there, your music will play, it'll be real exciting, you'll have something to be excited about, and then I'll beat the brakes off this cross-eyed halfwit.
Yeah!
LA, I understand you challenged Odyssey Jones to a match next week. Do you feel like you bit off a little bit more than you can chew?
Huh? What are you, president of this fan club? I'm not going to let some newbie walk in here, open up his big fat head hole, and just spew out a bunch of BS about the million-dollar megastar. No, no, doesn't work that way.
LA Knight, I may be new on campus, but I promise you, you have never, ever seen anyone like me in the ring.
I'm the star of the
Yeah, I've seen guys just like it, and this is how. I'll see you next week. Yeah!
It's just a simple fact that here comes this guy just waltzing in off the street. Grayson Waller. Never even heard of him until 2 days ago. And he's like, oh, mate, I'd like to host NXT Halloween Havoc, please. Nah. So, Grayson Waller, I hope you got all the likes. I hope you got all the tweets, all the swipes, everything you were possibly looking for out of mentioning my name. But you found out exactly where you stand.
You have to give credit to Grayson Waller. He went toe-to-toe with the NXT champion.
Yeah, I'm going
to
give him credit, because while he was out there and he lost, the entire NXT universe out there said, Waller sucks! And they're right, Waller does suck.
Your facts are destructive and harmful. The reality is, we should be building each other up, not tearing each other down.
You know what? You know what's really harmful and destructive right now? It's the buildup of me wanting to tear you down.
Mr. Knight, have no fear. Our safe space is right out there. And it's always open.
Why are you gonna make it sound like such a perverse thing, you creep? Here's how it goes down. Open that. Open the safe space. I swear, there won't be any microaggressions. Don't fear about that. There might be a little bit of ruthless aggression, maybe. But what you can bet on 100% for sure is you getting your ass stomped. And what that means is on Sunday, man, you ain't gotta like us. You don't even have to respect us. Because once the cage comes down, once the rings are in place, these four men step in the ring, brother, you got to understand, each and every one of you will get the respect stomped out of each and every one of your asses.
Hold on.
You're gonna come out here and talk to me about Grayson Waller? Huh? Wrong? Talking about the guy who did one halfway cool move at War Games with help, and all of a sudden he thinks he's special. Meanwhile, last week he comes out here and gets all butt hurt because some little fine chickadee was feeling that Kevorka of LA Knight. Yeah! And then what'd he do? He went out and threw a hissy fit like the incel he is. Well, here's what I need you to do. Somebody go out and find Grayson Waller. Tell him I'm here. Tell him to come find me if I don't find his ass first. Yeah!
I just saw AJ Styles whip Grayson Waller's ass. And I got to say, you did it phenomenally. Yeah! Let's not misunderstand something, because Grayson Waller, this just begun. Because I got to tell you, it's been weeks, and it's just been brewing up here, and I've been waiting to get that piece, and this tonight, just a little taste. Grayson Waller, your ass belongs to L.A. Knight. Yeah! Grayson Waller, go ahead and bring your scrawny ass out here so I can finish what I started last week. You know, that's about what I expected. You know, I have to turn my back to get you out here? Because we all know you ain't gonna look in these eyes. Week after week, there's a sound that you hear where you hear, Grayson sucks.
Grayson sucks.
As much as that, as much much as that chaps your ass, there's one sound that just haunts you. There's one sound that brings a feeling to you that you can't quite describe, and that's the name of the man who's going to drop you on your head with everybody saying L.A. Knight. Yeah! Because let's go ahead and go on back to Halloween Havoc. You tried to sabotage the car so I couldn't make it. But guess what? You couldn't get the job done. So then we go on to War Games. You do one halfway cool move. People think you're kind of cool. Actually, nobody except yourself. And you figure, hey man, maybe that took out LA Knight. Nah. You couldn't get the job done. So then a couple nights later, you get all upset because here's this sweet little chickadee outside. She turns you down because she knew the Kavorka of LA Knight. Yeah. But you know why she turned you down? Because she knew you couldn't get the job done. Grayson Waller, it's real simple. You can lift this restraining order and get dropped on your head by LA Knight, or you can get put to sleep by Dexter Lumis. Either way, you're getting your ass kicked.
Winning the Royal Rumble, main eventing WrestleMania, and then maybe coming down. Checking out the kids, kicking the door down. Bob, you know the directions,
right? I know the area. I know the area a little bit.
It's probably a good idea, actually, to focus on the Royal Rumble, because if it ends up like it just did out there, that's going to be a sad day. Yeah.
Mr. Knight, it appears you have a lot of anger in your heart. Harlan once had to move on from an unfair restraining order placed on him, and if you're open to it, I can help you grow and move on from this, just like I did for Harlan.
You'd do that for me?
Of course.
Okay. Well, I'll tell you what, actually, you gave me an even better idea. Tonight, why don't we all move on together? We'll move on out to that arena right there, and if we play our cards right, I'll have two more restraining orders by the end of the night. You and your little dog, because you will get your ass stomped. Tonight, what you set up, Sangha, myself, 1 week, I got to tell you, if I got to walk in there, chop that tree down. Grayson Waller, you've got to understand, soon enough, you will be next. You will be the one dropped on your head, and there ain't a damn thing you can do about it.
And right there it was. Right there you saw it. Officers, I ain't no legal beagle. But he knows, I know, they know. Most importantly, you should know. According to page 2 of this order, it reads, yes, LA Knight cannot touch Grayson Waller. But Grayson Waller cannot touch LA Knight. What that means, what that means is that this order ain't worth the paper it's written on, you dumb son of a b-.
Well, while the coward Waller doesn't come alone, that ain't gonna help you tonight. Oh!
Next week, you, me, your ass gets stomped out by the one, the only, with everybody saying, yeah! I'm sorry. Look at this, Grayson Waller. You've done enough to get yourself 3 fans out here. Good job. So I'm gonna put it to you like this. That's 2 times. You and me one-on-one in this ring, every single time I've walked out standing tall with your ass laying. So I tell you what, you're all about your likes, you're all about your tweets, your DMs, and this past week, I got a good feeling you were about some blocks. Because everybody on Twitter has been calling you out for the punk you are because you got your ass whipped in the middle of this ring one more time.
I'm going viral one more time. Grayson Waller will be last man standing.
I was hoping you'd say that. I was hoping you'd say that because next week, one more time, 3rd time's a charm. Nah, because your ass is laid out. I'm the one standing, not because you're not good enough, but because I won't let you.
I am a fighting champion.
But I only fight superstars. Maybe next time, kid.
You're right. I'm not a superstar. I'm a damn megastar. And what that means is any day of the week, I can take that title off of you. You come out here and you say, this is your show, right? Yeah. Nah. Orlando, tell them whose show this is. So if you want to come in here and tell me this is your show, show me.
You're competing for the NXT title tonight.
Yeah.
Well, it's good for you, but let me tell you this. You didn't get that because of your skill. You talked yourself into it. You use your voice a lot, and I don't respect it. I don't see a champion in front of me. The only thing I see is an embarrassment to this great sport.
I'm gonna tell you something. You talk about my mouth. I think the word you're looking for is charisma. If you just look around a little bit, you might find it.
I don't need to look for anything.
Oh, you do need to look for it, because here's the thing, man. It's called sports entertainment. You got the first half of that. I am both. Now, if you don't mind, I got a match to get ready for. Yeah.
Let me talk to you.
You shut up. I talk. You listen. You represent everything that is wrong in this sport today. Lots of talking, very little skill. You can talk yourself into championship matches, but you do not have what it takes to win them. Your mouth gets you in those matches, but it doesn't win them for you.
Listen to me very carefully. If you ever interrupt me one more time, I will knock your block head off your dad body, you dumb son of a bitch. I'll put it to you like this. Stand and Deliver's right around the corner. I was gonna use my words to set up a match. But since you don't like me using my words, I figure I'll try a different route.
Wow. While you're out here, saying maybe the things that I might say, why don't I say some of the things that you would say? Welcome to SmackDown Lowdown. We wanna talk about Maximum Male Models, Massey and Mansoir, right? Wrong. Because where are they? Getting flushed down the toilet right about now. Why is that? Because Massey, Mansoir, both of them dropped on their head for their troubles.
Let me handle a little business here, because this little Pop-Tart announcer over here just couldn't happen to get my hometown right a couple weeks ago. Believe me, I understand it. What you were feeling was the undeniable Kaborka of L.A. Knight. You got lost in these baby blues, but even though you got it right tonight, that intro you just did, that ain't good enough for the megastar. It might be good enough for this gymnastic jerk up here.
Because I can't stop this gravy train. I can't stop. What are you looking at? Is that more interesting than I am right now? Can't fix that. Go ahead and turn this trash off. Because I don't need his stuff here. This is my time.
I'm asking you, how far are you willing to go?
How far I'm willing to go? Ain't any of your damn business, but how far you're willing to go should be back to your little romper room, play with your little puppets, stick them anywhere that gives you pleasure. It's okay with me.
You just talked about fear. You just talked about respect. As I look in your eyes, there's something that tells me that last week, the fact that I didn't fear you maybe garnered me some respect. I'm not sure what to make of your apology, but as I look into your eyes, I think you do respect me. And so for that, I just want... Now we're even. Apology accepted. Apology accepted, okay? That's it.
We're even, right? Even. We're even?
Why? That's my house. That's how I do that. Now, how's that taste? How's that taste? How's it feel, Arden? Because it looks pretty good.
Excuse me, LA Knight. We just heard what Bray Wyatt had to say.
If you ain't talking about me, then you ain't talking. So let me talk to you. Because 7 days ago, as I'm leaving the arena, just minding my own business, next thing I know, I end up getting pulled out from underneath a pile of Bray.
A pile of what?
A pile of trash.
I thought you just said a pile
of... Exactly. I knew you'd see it my way. And now that human trash bag gets to stand out there, vomit his lies to the world, and not a single consequence. Isn't that pretty? Well, you know, it took everything in me today to hobble in here. And if not for this sling, and if not for these crutches, the consequences would be severe. I would look him in the eyes, and I would say, whose game is it? And he would shiver and quiver in fear, and he would say, it's LA Knight's game. And then I would proceed to kick his keister in front of everybody.
Bray Wyatt. Figures you puppets would do that. Week after week, I get blindsided. And then you say to everybody, I didn't do it. I said, well, actually, if I did do it, there'd be none of them left. Right? Wrong. Go ahead, take a look right there. No, not that fat head right there. I mean that mask in the background. If you need any more evidence, you'd have to be a cross-eyed half-wit to not tell that was him. I didn't ask any of you shut up because I got business to deal with. All you've done since you've returned is dress like a damn circus freak. You've whined and cried with your victim complex. You've said a bunch of gobbledygook that never gets to the point. And you say, well, it wasn't me, my brother. It was Boy Howdy. You don't know. I know! I know who it was! I know it was you. I can hear you. I can feel you. So here's what I need you to do. I need you to put on whatever mask you need to. I need you to put on whatever costume you need to. Call yourself anything you need to so that you can walk down here and you can get stomped out. Oh, I want to apologize to the little cameraman. You got to be kidding me. The master of the mind games, Bray Wyatt, getting gamed by the man they call the megastar, L.A. Knight. What happened to you, man? You can't even keep your composure out here. You can't even finish a sentence, and then you get all embarrassed, and you take it out on the poor cameraman. What I am concerned about is you pay one of your goons to come on down here in your Captain Howdy outfit, and you think that takes the heat off you, right? No. You're still a responsible party, and it's time to pay the check. But hear this. You know, you used to be something. You used to be a force. Hey, pipe down. I didn't ask none of you. I'm talking. You used to be something. But week after week, all you've proven yourself to be is a fraud, a broke-down loser, yeah? But I got the medicine. The Royal Rumble's coming down the pike. It's going to be my first. And my God, do I want to make it a special one. And I tell you how I'm going to do that. Huh? Shut up, dummies, I'm talking. The way I'm going to do that is by taking you and putting you out of your misery when I break your ass like dishes.
Now, you've allowed me the great opportunity to show Bray Wyatt as the shortest WWE return in history. One match in, one match out, never seen again. Quite frankly, Bray, I've heard enough about you. I've heard enough of his little monsters. Fans missed you, right? I mean, all social media was abuzz, hoping you would make your triumphant return. If I'm honest, I was one of those fans. I actually got goosebumps just thinking about what bringing you back would feel like. And now I get my hands on you after all this time. Mountain Dew Pitch Black is back, baby! Yeah! What? There's no way you possibly thought I was really excited for that cross-eyed half-wit Bray Wyatt, did you? You do know what Mountain Dew Pitch Black and Bray Wyatt have in common, right? They're both available for a limited time. Yeah, get them while you can. Bray Wyatt goes,
darkness is coming, my brother. My opponents will feel my wrath. I didn't do it. If I did, there'd be none of them left.
Whatever that stupid crap is. Because at the Royal Rumble, there's going to be two things pitch black. Mountain Dew and the career of Bray Wyatt.
I found myself earlier today walking through Memphis, and I thought to myself, do I really feel the way I feel? Yeah, I feel damn good. Not because I'm in Memphis. Nobody feels good about that. Pipe down, Memphis. Because at the Royal Rumble, when the lights go down, Bray Wyatt's lights go out. Can someone help Bray Wyatt figure out what the hell's going on? One week he's not Uncle Howdy. The next week, I am Uncle Howdy. I am him. Huh? I'm the guy at Royal Rumble who's going to make you think to yourself, maybe I shouldn't have come back. Maybe I should have stayed away. After all, it is LA Knight's game. Because while you've been living check to check on past glory, walk on into the LA Knight Bank and find out those checks ain't worth trash. Because whether it's pitch black
Whether it's broad daylight at Royal Rumble, I will off here on Switch just like that. Yeah. Yeah. Shut up.
Tonight we saw the return of Bray Wyatt's Firefly Funhouse. How does that, if at all, affect your preparation for the Royal Rumble?
You're serious right now. You're serious. How's that affect my preparation? Does that change anything? What, guy brings out a couple little puppets. Oh, that's cool. Great. Grown man playing with puppets. Great. Good for him. Tell you what, while he's playing with puppets, he's only got 8 days. And in 8 days, he finds out that everything that he's built up means nothing. He wanted to walk his way into my light. He wanted to walk his way into my path. And now he's going to find out that doesn't end well. That doesn't end well at all, because at the Royal Rumble, pitch black match gets dropped on his head for his troubles. BFT all night. Last Friday on SmackDown, Bray Wyatt brought back the Firefly Funhouse. Yippee! A grown man incel playing with puppets with spooky music. And I'm supposed to be scared of that. Huh? Wrong! If I was any more a man, there'd be two of me standing here right now.
The man that main event.
That's enough. Cut that. Cut that. Cut that. I heard what you said on Joe Rogan about the locker room being soft. Hey, I agree with you. You look back there, there's a bunch of softies back there. Top of the list is Bray Wyatt. Let's just think about something here. Think of the irony of the headline that we can create right now. LA Knight sends the Undertaker to the Undertaker. Yeah! So I'll tell you what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna give you a pass. I'm gonna let you live to see another day. I'm gonna let you live to enjoy retirement. Enjoy your family. Oh, but I want you to watch the pitch black match at Royal Rumble, because after that, they're gonna be calling me the Lord of Darkness. Yeah!
Tomorrow night at the Alamo Dome, the Royal Rumble event.
I heard y'all chanting, talk to us, talk to us. And being the benevolent man that I am, I give you what you want, even though you don't deserve it. Here comes the Undertaker to assist Bray Wyatt. Why is that? Pipe down, I'm talking. Why is that? Because neither of them wanted this guy one-on-one. Yeah. 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 I said pipe down, I'm talking. This right here, this is your future. Torn up, laid out. Because when the Alamo Dome goes pitch black, your dumpy ass ain't coming back.
Who are you to be demanding anything right now?
I don't recall inviting the Nerd Day down here. You gotta understand something. I don't care about your path. I don't care what you did. I'm a creator of circumstance, not a creature of circumstance. And the circumstance that I create is a circumstance that's advantageous to me. And by the way, Kofi, how'd that little Kofi Mania thing work out for you anyway? Somebody talking about the Intercontinental title, then you get to be talking about L.A. Knight. Yeah! Meanwhile, you two are handed every single opportunity, and still you cry!
Oh, you're just over here signing autographs, huh? You know, I tell you what, if you're not gonna fight your little goofy son, I'll fight him. I'll give him an L.A. moment. Matter of fact, maybe, tell you what, I'm gonna make you proud. I'll call myself L.A. Mysterios. I'll be a deadbeat dad too. High five on that one, huh?
LA, congratulations. Thanks to an assist from Dominic Mysterio,
sorry,
you were
really
able...
really confused, and I understand why you are, because now you're talking about assist. No. The only thing that got assisted out there was me assisting myself to a win over a Hall of Famer. Man's about to go into the Hall of Fame next week, and guess what? He had to lay down and count them lights while the referee was counting the three for the one, the only L.A. Knight.
And you know, I watched WrestleMania, and there was just one big glaring omission. You see Snoop Dogg, you see Bad Bunny, you see Logan Paul, and I just can't help but think we're in L.A., and there's one thing missing, with everybody saying LA Knight. But then I think, well, it is WrestleMania. And then here's this guy on there for playing video games. How times have changed. I tell you what, this ain't playing one of your little video games. You can be playing LA Knight's game. Yeah. Did I lose? Did you see me lose there? Did you see my shoulders get pinned to the mat? Did you see me tap out? Did you see me get counted out? Did you see me get disqualified? No, no, you didn't see none of that. What you saw was another man get beat. What you saw was me sitting outside trying to get back in, but being held by the illegal guy. That's what you saw. What you saw, what everybody out there saw, what everybody in here saw, was a loser in Rick Boogs. What everybody saw was a man who didn't get the opportunity to do what I still need to do to the Street Profits. Oh, but it will come. The time will come. Boys, you got to understand something. If I'm telling you, you're gonna pay the piper, toot toot, you go pay the piper. He is I, and I am him.
You guys been out here talking trash the whole time. Don't think I don't know. You keep talking, I'll make change out of both your $5 asses. What I just showed you, what everybody just saw is an example of me taking out the trash. And you got to know your time's coming. And what that means is you say, we want the smoke. No, no, you ain't gonna get the smoke. You're gonna get smoked.
Welcome to LA's Corner. This is where I hang out in the backstage area. Yeah, because I go wherever I want. Any party I want to go to, that's where I am. And the party I'm going to is Money in the Bank. Montez Ford thinks he's gonna stand in the way of that. Huh? No, no. Here's the deal, man. Talk about Street Profits. I'm talking street losses, brother. Here's the way it goes down. Montez Ford goes down, and like dominoes, the entire Street Profits fall to the side, and you watch me walk into Money in the Bank, climb that ladder, and move on to any title that I want.
LA, congratulations on your victory. You're now heading into a career-altering match at Money in the Bank, along with Shinsuke Nakamura, Ricochet, and more competitors will be added this week. But how do you prepare for...
Yeah, that's a lot of fluff you're getting into right now. Let's just go ahead and skip to what matters. The one thing that matters is the one man standing next to you right now, and it just makes me think, you know, they talk Money in the Bank. Well, if you're talking money and you're talking the bank, then let me talk to you, because here stands the man, the only man that matters in any of those names that you mentioned. Who's going to be in this match? Huh? Does it matter? 6 guys, 7 guys, 8 guys, 10 guys. Doesn't make a difference, because one man will climb, make the acclivity up to that ladder, grab that briefcase, and after that, any title I want. All I can tell you is if you're holding some gold title out there, keep your eyes out, because I'm coming for you.
Escobar,
he's sitting here.
Now, LA Knight, finally, your microphone is on. Welcome, sir. And what brings you out here to watch the Escobar-Ali matchup?
Well, I'm out here just protecting my investment, but if you cut me off again, I'll slap those glasses off your fat head.
I agree. What a terrible introduction that was.
Un sueño. Es.
Well, here's one man I can guarantee you is fighting for nobody but himself.
Yeah. He is fighting for the legions of fans around planet Earth who are aboard the LA Knight bandwagon. You're not welcome on it either. You never will be on it. The train left the station a long time ago, pal.
I look in this ring and I see Ricochet, I see Nakamura, and I see two guys who are as useless as basketball cleats. Then I look and I see a guy. He makes videos for 14-year-old girls and wants to call himself a megastar. No, no! But I'll tell you what, Logan Paul, I brought you a little gift. It's a map. If you follow this, you'll find the exact directions of where you can stick each and every one of those bottles of Prime. Yeah! You know what? I'm going to give you one thing, Logan Paul. You have proven a lot with everything you've been given. But that's the key. It's what you've been given. Meanwhile, I've walked in here, I ain't been given a damn thing, yet every time I walk in here, the whole world jumps to their feet, feeling the Kavorka, because I made it that way. Yeah. So here's the thing, man, I got all the respect in the world for the fact that you could go make yourself a name on social media, you could make yourself a name on YouTube, but right now, you're standing in my ring. Because I am the one and the only megastar with everybody saying, L.A. Knight. I tell you what, if you ain't heard, you ain't listening hard enough. London, tell them whose game this is.
All of a sudden, LA Knight's everywhere, huh? Everybody wants to use my name. Everybody on the internet wants to use my name to get views and clicks. Let's call it what it is. I'm the best decision this company ever made. Because I stand head and shoulders above. Nobody back there can touch me. You got to understand something. You can call me the megastar. Hell, if you want to, you can call me the GOAT. But sooner or later, one way or another, you will be calling me champ. Yeah? Because whose game is it? With everybody saying.